probably noticed, I went to see Spider-Man No Way Home, the fourth and final film in 2021 for the Marvel Cinematic Universe, and it was amazing. A lot of surprises, everything that just reminded me why I love these movies in the first place. Now, I know I'm sounding overgeneralistic because I'm a huge Marvel fan. I'm not. This was amazing. And considering the fact that we've heard rumors that this could be the last time Tom Holland plays Spider-Man, Peter Parker in the MCU, this was incredibly special. I mean, everyone was amazing at it. Holland, Zendaya, Jacob Barton, including, not to mention Marisa Tomei and John Fairview, not to mention Benedict Cumberbatch appearing as Doctor Strange, and by now, you've probably seen the previews. Doc Ock is back, Alfred Molina, Jamie Foxx is back as Electro, William Dafoe is back as the Green Goblin. That's all I'm gonna say. The rest of it, you gotta see yourself. But I will say this, if you want a reference, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. There, I said, that's all I'm saying. Now, 2024, a lot of people thought it was oversaturated with Marvel films and Marvel content, not just on the big screen, but in Disney Plus. And it was to a point, but let's put it in perspective. In 2020, we got the coronavirus, and it shut down theaters for an extended period of time. And let's not forget that a lot of the production for Disney Plus was frozen as well. So this year, 2021, was amazing for Marvel Studios. We got four amazing films on which I've done reviews for, but let's do a small review. For one, Black Widow. We've been waiting for this movie for years, and we finally got it. The only real thing I have a problem with is that it should have been done years ago. I mean, like, literally years ago, right after Iron Man 2, or possibly, as the storyline showed, after Captain America Civil War. The second film, obviously one of my all-time favorites from this year, and one of my all-time favorites, period, right up there with Black Panther, Shang-Chi, The Legend of the Ten Rings. Simu Yu did an amazing job bringing this incredible character to life. That's all that needs to be said about it. The third film, and one that a lot of you Marvel fans were screaming for, and we finally got, The Eternals. Could have been better, but it was still an amazing film to watch. And of course, Spider-Man Far From No Way Home. Jeez, I get those two mixed up all the time. And of course, there's the Disney Plus television series, starting with the award-winning, critically acclaimed, one of my favorites, WandaVision. Elizabeth Olsen and Paul Bettany returning as Wanda Maximoff and the Vision have just been amazing. And it goes, serves as a pivot point to what will be coming out next year. Oh crap, I shouldn't have said that. Well, cat's out of the bag now if you haven't watched it on YouTube. Anyhow, the second, of course, was my all-time favorite, the one I've been waiting for personally, The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. And we see Sam Wilson and Bucky Barnes in his team-up, and we see The Falcon embrace his destiny as becoming the next Captain America. And of course, the animated series that was incredibly imaginative, What If? Jeffrey Rush did an amazing job playing the voice of the Watcher. Not to mention a lot of actors from the Marvel Cinematic Universe appearing as their regular characters. Say, for example, Benedict Cumberbatch returned as Doctor Strange. Tilda Swinton as the Ancient One. Captain Carter, or Agent Carter, if you want to call him, being played again by Haley Atwell. And of course, the final performances from Chadwick Boseman as Black Panther, as T'Challa, or Star-Lord T'Challa, whichever way you want to call it in these episodes. Of course, the television series Loki, Tom Hiddleston returning back as the God of Mischief, Owen Wilson in as his partner, it was just amazing to watch. And of course, just before Christmas, Hawkeye. What can I say about it? If the rumors are true, again, I'm not sure if they are true or not, this could be the last time we see Jeremy Renner as Clint Bartlett, or at the very least, as Hawkeye. Now, Hayley Steinfeld, she's an amazing actress. I'm looking forward to seeing what happens if she continues to play this particular character. If she begins to play, if she continues to play Hawkeye, I can't wait for what happens next. And not to mention the fact that we might have a new Black Widow, maybe. Florence Pug, she's amazingly funny in that role. Just as funny as Scarlett Johansson was as Natasha Romanoff. Now, obviously, Marvel isn't slowing down. Marvel isn't stopping. We already got a small preview of the next Doctor Strange film, Madness in the Multiverse. Multiverse of Madness. I get those two mixed up too. I can't wait to see what happens next in 2022. And I hope every one of you will be with me watching these films as they come out. Now, if you have a favorite from 2021, please write it in the description below. Oh, comment, let me know what you think. And in the very amazing tradition of Mr. Stan Lee, Excelsior.